So, hi, I'm at the Aftership HQ with Janet. So, thanks for joining us.
Welcome.
So, yeah, I'm really excited to be here. And a lot of candidates and Canopy members are very interested to know, you know, any good tips. So, it'd be good to hear from an HR. What are your main tips and anything that's impressed you?
Sure. So I'll talk in a general sense. We actually don't call my role here HR. We actually call it people because we believe HR is quite standardized and black and white protocols, but people are alive. We're a startup. We need to be agile and flexible. So we call the role people. And I was actually essentially hired just to look after the people's well-being, make sure they're happy, make sure our culture is set on the right path. And then when the new joiners come, they can help us blossom and flourish and take us to the next level. So in terms of general advice for job-seeking candidates, I think being prepared is one. Not just, you know, memorizing the company website or regurgitating the info from there, but actually dive a little bit deeper into the industry, the product, and in terms of relative experience or even transferable experience from their previous roles. Even if you don't have the relevant transferable experience, what do you propose that you can add value in terms of the company? We're always thinking of people who can think outside the square and help boost us to the next level. So I think being prepared is one. In terms of also being prepared, be prepared to talk about things outside of the CV. Don't just memorize the CV. You're bringing a person into the interview. Your personality needs to come through, your passions, what you want to achieve in life, you know, your viewpoints. I think that's also very important. Look into the co-founder's background, for example, even the person who's going to interview you. That's a great tip. Know a little bit about them. Maybe even ask them questions about what they try to achieve or what have they achieved since they joined the company. The second one, being passionate, I think is a definite. I think I mentioned that already. But what are you passionate about? We're always looking for people who think beyond their role. So that engineers we hire, for example, we can actually put themselves into a product owner's brain for a bit, or think in terms of a designer aspect as well. And our designers and product owners can also be sensitive to engineering requirements. If you're passionate, you'll always try to push yourself to go above and beyond. So that's why our engineer bar is, for example, very high, even our designers and product owners as well, because they bring everything they can into, they don't even see it as a job. It's more seeing the task as a baby and how they want the baby to flourish. So always encouraging, every time I talk to job candidates, whatever challenge or whatever they hand in to me has to be something they're truly proud of. I always use the word proud, because if you're proud of it, then as I think it's contagious. The recipient will feel that as well. That's 2 points, I know very long, but thirdly, what I've been impressed with, for example, I have been here for nearly a year now. 2 candidates have responded to my job as a writing code to me.
Wow.
So I found that to be absolutely, it gives me goosebumps actually. Mm. It gets me very inspired to talk to them. So I think try to think in terms of how you're going to impress and get your foot in the door. I think that's very important. So maybe a tailored portfolio, you know, a very tailored cover letter maybe, or just making sure that you are showcasing everything you're proud of on a CV. That's for the job applicants. For companies who are looking to hire people, don't just look at the CV and tick your job requirements. Think above and beyond. Talk to the stakeholders. Would they be open to looking at someone from different backgrounds who can bring maybe new blood or new ideas into the firm? Don't just look at a checklist and tick boxes. I think that's very important in terms of a people role, because whoever you bring in will help the company be flourish. But if you rule people out, then you just might miss out on that golden opportunity.
Yeah, that's fantastic advice. So thank you.